I am Panos Papadopoulos. I am the founder CEO at Baxens. Baxens is a quality monitoring application. Right now, we track about 6% of all Android applications, and therefore we are the third most used SDK for Android after Google Analytics and Flare, according to Ubrain.
Hello, I'm Maria. I'm a PhD candidate student at Athens University of Economics and Business, and I am in the Software Engineering and Security group of my university under the supervision of Professor Diomidis Pinelis.
So you're here because of Android bugs. And let's face it, everybody has bugs. We have companies that say, we don't need your service because, you know, our code is perfect, we test and there's no bugs. There is no fucking way never to have bugs. Even if you don't have bugs, maybe Android or the SDKs you have going to have bugs. And still users are going to have a bad experience. And you have to track it down. But there are some good news here. A lot of the errors are pretty much standard. So we'll find out later why they happen. And we'll give you tips on how to solve them. And maybe sometime in the future, there's no need for us if you make everything perfect. So we started this research last year. So we analyzed data from last year, when we only had 320 million devices using the Baxens, and we analyzed just 40 million crashes. This year, our numbers have about tripled. Of course, not the devices. The devices are half to half billion. They're not 900 million. And what we have discovered, first of all, is that about 18% of all users using your app will be affected by a crash at some point of their life. And this will lead to losing 5% of your user base because of the crashes. And we also found out that if an error continues to exist in the next two versions after it was first introduced, with a certainty of 82%, the user will stop using your app. So it's a very bad idea, you know, to have bugs there that you know that they exist and not solving them, you know, as you release new versions.
Well, currently in my laboratory, we are doing research regarding telemetry data. We try to understand. Telemetry data are from mobile crashes that we have received from Baxens, and they are in the form of stack traces, and we try to understand the crash causes behind these stack traces and evaluate the APIs. So this is an overview of the process of our study. We received our dump from Baxens. We get the stack traces, we cleaned them, and reformed them into a format usable for our analysis. Then we used the heuristics in order to extract from the stack traces signatures that we will discuss for them in the next slide, in order to organize our data in crash categories. These crash categories helped us to understand API design problems and make some general suggestions for solutions. This is the heuristic function that we used in order to extract our signatures from our stack traces. In general, this function says that a method calls from the framework of the API can be lead to exceptions through API calls and application calls. So from our stack traces, we get three elements from each stack trace: the method of the API method, the exception related to the method, and the root exception. And then we get our signatures from our stack traces to understand the causes of crashes. This is a complex graph from method calls from our stack traces.
Yeah, so here you can see the call graph, which means, you know, if my app crashes and the next line is java.lang async thread, what's next? And this is it. As you can understand, it's a very complicated path, and there are many different paths. So the idea here is to find the most critical path and see why they're happening. So what do we have found out? We analyzed we took the errors and put them into categories. So later we're going to tell you exactly what exception is behind these categories. But as you can see, memory exhaustion. Who blames that the user has a crappy app with small memory has a problem? Of course, it's not your problem, it's the device. Bitmaps. We'll see more details. But as you can see, the two most The main categories for crashes are memory exhaustion, race conditional deadlocks, of course. Who wants to deal with threads? Not me. So then, of course, there are other things like indexing problems, connectivity, improper component identification, sufficient permissions. Sometimes you may add something new, you forget to add a permission, or maybe you deleted a component and you release a new version without it, and then it's crashing. So now we'll get into the details. And what we have found, first of all, is 86% of the errors are yours. So I'm sorry for that, but you knew it already. 3% they are in the Android and SDK content. So sometimes it can be Android that's causing your app to crash, or some of the third-party SDKs that you're using, specifically ad networks. We have seen tons of errors coming from ad networks. And last, it's API context. What does it mean? It means that 11% of your errors are caused because you don't use the API properly, or because the APIs are not documented very well, or they have changed from version to version. So this is where Google should take some initiatives and improve the documentation of the APIs, and sometimes even improve the APIs itself. Maria was telling me about an example when you pass null to the function, and then when you do dot get, you get null. And of course you get a nice null pointer exception. So Maria, please help us explain what are the main issues and how to fix them.
Okay, now we will present five categories and some representative signature examples and some design API design suggestions. So this is the memory exhaustion category, and in this category we have included errors like memory leaks. In order to avoid such crashes, the API can include a resource authorized interface, a restricted use of cache structure like the LRU cache, chip file formats like vector images, and auto-adopted heap memory. Also, the programmers can use profiling tools in order to catch problems that can lead to these crashes.
Yeah, one other note is that we have seen that a lot of times one of the file formats that causes a lot of memory exhaustion is XML parsing. I don't know what people are sending there, but we have seen like XML files that like 25 megabytes. Really, there's no point for that. Your app will crash no matter what. So next.
Okay. Another top category refers to race conditions and deadlocks. So in this category, we have included crashes because of synchronization problems related to collections, to threads, and to the database. In order to avoid such problems, the API should include non-blocking algorithms like the async task, and the developers can use verification tools and static checking in order to find problems quite early. Another category refers to the missing or corrupt resources. Here we have included problems because a resource cannot be opened, like here an audio file. Here the API can use default resources like a layout. In order, so if there is no resource, it will not throw an null exception, but an exception about this resource.
Yeah, so be careful. If users they swipe out their data, missing SD cards, you should always have a check for that.
Another category is improper component identification. Here we have included crashes because a component hasn't been declared correctly into the manifest XML file, like an activity. In order to avoid such errors, the API can use more meaningless codes, which the developers can remember easily. And the last of our categories that we present here is the insufficient permission, permissions that haven't been declared into the manifest file for an activity. This occurs because the API hasn't got a good documentation about these activities and the permissions that they should have. So there should be better documentation to avoid these crashes.
So what we have seen constantly is like about this is 80% of the data The root cause is one of these. Null pointer exception.
Yeah.
Usually when you try to access the, an array and something is missing.
Yeah,
out of memory error, you know, bitmaps, try to resize your map. As we said, you know, send smaller data, smaller assets if your app is using less CPU or smaller screen. And of course, you know, you have to be sensitive and you have to track, you know, for example, if there are users that are using this old Ericsson Xperia device that has, I don't know, 100 kilobytes of RAM, then you should be very careful or not support it. Illegal argument exception, that's maybe your app. And you should always try to get notified at least for Android API changes, because we have also seen there a lot of things happening because the SDK changed and you used to reference wrong arguments. Runtime exception, which of course it's the most critical one.
Yes, it is quite generic, as well as the null pointer exception, and this could be a design problem in the API because the developers cannot understand exactly what the problem is. So, as we have seen in Stack Overflow, and
then of course is window manager bad token exception, those UIs under threads, if you use them. SQLite exceptions, we have seen a lot of problems in tables that maybe someone altered the table schema and then the app tries to read and everything goes to hell. Or when we drive a lot of threads try to access the SQLite and still there is an issue. Of course, the index out of bounds exception. And finally, the file not found exception, which is much less than the null pointer exception. So, though it was the so what are the 10 APIs that result in 17% of the crashes? Guesses? So, these are. These 10 APIs will be responsible for 17% of all crashes. So, what you have to do, study them carefully. And the presentation will be available after the conference for study. And be careful when you use these APIs. So finally, we just released live monitoring of all crashes that are happening around the world. As we told you, we're now in 520 million devices. You'll be able to track what are the top exceptions per OS version and device. And one of the first to tweet will get a Mastiha liqueur, which is great, especially if you want to celebrate your new release or you have a lot of errors and you have to forget about them and before you go to the office the next day. So one of the first 10 to tweet about our live infographic will get this Mastiha liqueur, which is quite unique. That's it. Thank you. And of course, everybody who tweets will get a 20% discount on Buxons. We're open to questions.